Today we have come with very important topic, that is depreciation on goodwill. Provision about depreciation on goodwill has been recently changed under the Income Tax Act, in Finance Act 2021 only. So before I give you the brief about this amendment on depreciation on goodwill, I will first explain you in very short that what is depreciation on goodwill and how it is allowed, and it was being allowed previously, and how it will be allowed in future or not. Now I will deal with that. So under the Income Tax Act, kisi bhi cheez pe agar depreciation milta hai, to that must come under the definition of block of asset, jo ki defined hai section 2 subsection 11 of the Income Tax Act, jo ki aap yahan pe dekh sakte hain. A group of asset falling within a class of asset comprising tangible asset being building, machinery, plant or machinery, and tangible asset being intangible asset being know-how, patents, copyright, trademarks, licenses, franchises, and any other business or commercial rights of similar nature. तो इन सारे asset पे हमारे Income Tax Act में depreciation allowed होता है. यहाँ पे आप directly देख सकते हैं कि depreciation on goodwill. That means goodwill directly block of asset mein included nahi hai. It is written as intangible asset being know-how, patents, copyright, trademarks and license, and franchises and any other business or commercial right of similar nature. Since ye directly included nahi tha, to ispe litigation tha ki depreciation goodwill pe milna chahiye, and it will come under the meaning of any other business and commercial right of similar nature. To iske against mein बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट लैंडमार्क डिसीजन था सुप्रीम कोर्ट का इन द केस ऑफ स्मिथ सिक्योरिटीज लिमिटेड, जहां पे सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने डिक्लेयर कर दिया था, प्रोनाउंस कर दिया था कि गुडविल विल बी इंक्लूडेड विद इन द टर्म ऑफ एनी अदर बिजनेस और कमर्शियल राइट ऑफ सिमिलर नेचर, और उसके बेसिस पे अभी तक सब कोई गुडविल पे डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम कर रहे थे. बट Instead of that, कुछ practical difficulties has been noted by the Income Tax Department and the Revenue Department and the government. And those practical difficulties I will deal here. First है कि दो तरह का goodwill हो सकता है. एक goodwill तो होता है कि जो कि self generated होता है, जो कि लोग कोई purchase नहीं करते और उसका purchase price zero होता है, और एक goodwill होता है जो कि goodwill परचेज होता है, लाइक किसी का ब्रांड नेम से गुडविल परचेज और एनी बिजनेस नया परचेज होता है तो गुडविल ऑलरेडी रहता है, तो उसका कुछ पेमेंट अमाउंट होता है. तो दो तरह के गुडविल हुए, एक सेल्फ जनरेटेड और एक परचेज्ड. तो जो कि सेल्फ जनरेटेड गुडविल है, अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजन ऑफ इनकम टैक्स एक्ट, उसका कॉस्ट हमेशा निल रहता है. तो ये प्रैक्टिकली पॉसिबल नहीं था कि जो कि सेल्फ जनरेटेड गुडविल है उस पर डेप्रिसिएशन क्लेम करे. बट जो कि गुडविल अक्वायर्ड होते हैं, उसका कुछ परचेज वैल्यू होता है, और लोग उस पर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस सुप्रीम कोर्ट डिसीजन स्मिथ सिक्योरिटीज ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट में उसको कंसिडर करके डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम कर रहे थे. बट ये दोनों को आप जब एक साथ देखें तो ये बैलेंस नहीं है कि सेल्फ जनरेटेड पे गुडविल क्लेम नहीं कर सकते बिकॉज उसका परचेज वैल्यू निल होता है, बट अक्वायर्ड गुडविल पे डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम कर रहे हैं लोग बिकॉज उसका कुछ परचेज वैल्यू होते हैं. तो दिस क्रिएटेड अ अनबैलेंस सिनेरियो इन बोथ केसेस. सेकेंड डिफिकल्टी क्या था कि प्रैक्टिकली गुडविल एक्चुअल में डेप्रिशिएट होता नहीं है. इट टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ द बिजनेस रन्स, एंड इफ बिजनेस गोज वेल, इंस्टेड ऑफ डेप्रिशिएटिंग इट अप्रिशिएट्स. सो प्रैक्टिकली इट इज नॉट फीजिबल कि इवन द गुड बिजनेस इज गोइंग गुड एंड पीपल आर क्लेमिंग डेप्रिशिएशन ऑन गुडविल, इंस्टेड व्हेन एनीवन विल गो इनटू डीप इट इज एक्चुअली अप्रिशिएटिंग. तो इन दोनों डिफिकल्टीज को रिमूव करने के लिए गवर्नमेंट ने बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट अमेंडमेंट लाया है फिनेंस एक्ट 2021 में, टू स्पेसिफिकली एक्सक्लूड गुडविल फ्रॉम द मीनिंग ऑफ ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट. वहां पे उन्होंने क्लियर प्रोविजंस ला दिए हैं कि डेप्रिशिएशन पूरे इनकम टैक्स एक्ट में जहां जहां भी इम्पोर्टेंट है, रेलिवेंट है, गुडविल को स्पेसिफिकली एक्सक्लूड कर दिए कि ये ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट में इंक्लूड नहीं होगा, इस पर डेप्रिशिएशन और फर्दर क्लेम नहीं कर सकते. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जो लोग भी डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम कर रहे थे गुडविल में, बी अलर्ट, नो मोर डेप्रिशिएशन कैन बी क्लेम्ड ऑन गुडविल, वेदर इट इज सेल्फ अक्वायर्ड और इट इज परचेस्ड. सो नो मोर डिसीजन ऑफ स्मिथ सिक्योरिटीज लिमिटेड हेल्ड बाय सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैन बी फॉलोड नाउ. अब इसमें कुछ फर्दर डिफिकल्टी आ सकती थी क्योंकि डेप्रिशिएशन अब गुडविल पे क्लेम नहीं कर सकते हैं, बट जो लोग पहले ही फिनेंशियल ईयर 2020-21 के, लाइक 1 अप्रैल 2020 के पहले ही गुडविल अक्वायर किए हैं और वो डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम कर चुके हैं, तो उनके ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट में आ रहा होगा, उसको रेक्टिफाई करने के लिए रूल 8AC हैज बीन इंसर्टेड लास्ट मंथ ओनली ऑन 7th जुलाई 2021, जहाँ पे कुछ रेक्टिफिकेशन एडजस्टमेंट बताए गए हैं कि हाउ टू रिमूव द इफेक्ट ऑफ डेप्रिशिएशन क्लेम्ड एंड ऑन गुडविल एंड हाउ टू रिमूव इट फ्रॉम द ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट इफ इट वॉज इंक्लूडेड बिफोर फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2020-21. तो इसका फॉर्मूला दिया है कि कंसिडर goodwill to be only asset of the block of asset and calculate depreciation till 31st march 2020 and reduce it from actual cost of purchase of goodwill. For example, let's say goodwill was purchased for ₹1000, that is purchase value was ₹1000 and the accumulated depreciation claimed on it till 31st march 2020, that is before financial year 2020-21, accumulated depreciation is ₹300. So the opening written down value as on 1st April 2020, that starting of financial year 2020, opening written down value of goodwill will be ₹1000 minus ₹300, that is ₹700. This is calculated in the way like assuming goodwill is the only asset in the block of asset, and then calculate the accumulated depreciation, that is ₹300, and the opening written down value comes to ₹1000 minus 300, that is ₹700. This ₹700 will be adjusted from the block of asset in which it was included till 31st March 2020, that is before financial year 2020-21, that is in the financial year 1920, in which block of asset it was included, the remaining amount of goodwill calculated, that is ₹700, will be reduced from that relevant block of asset, and that relevant block of asset will be free of goodwill effect, if any. So this is very clear. ₹1000 minus 300, that is accumulated depreciation, purchase value minus accumulated depreciation on goodwill will be reduced from the particular block of asset in which goodwill was included before, that is in financial year 1920. It may also happen that the adjusted value of goodwill is more than the written down value of that particular block of asset as on 1st April 2020. For example, say opening written down value of that particular block of asset in which goodwill was included is ₹600 only, and the adjusted amount to be adjusted is coming to be ₹700, as explained earlier, that is 1000 minus 300. The adjusted amount that is to be adjusted for goodwill is 700, but the written down value of the particular block of asset is ₹600 only. Then what we will do that of that excess of ₹700 minus 600, that excess will be treated as short-term capital gain in the financial year 2020-21. This is very important. If the amount for goodwill that is required to be adjusted from any particular block of asset is coming more than the written down value of that block of asset, then excess will be treated as short-term capital gain. In our example, it is ₹100. For example, our block of asset excluding goodwill effect is only ₹600. But the amount that is required to be adjusted for giving past effect of goodwill, that is 1000 purchase value minus accumulated depreciation, 1000 minus 300, 7 is equal to 700, is more than the written down value, that is 600 rupees 100 will be treated as short term capital gain in the financial year 2020-21. It may also happen that ki kisi kisi ka sirf goodwill hi ka ek particular block of asset hai aur usme aur koi intangible asset nahi hai aur koi asset nahi hai. Then what we will do, simply we will remove that block of asset. No capital gain and no capital loss will occur in that case. It has been specifically clarified in rule 8AC that no specific capital gain or loss will be calculated for goodwill if any block of asset comprises only of goodwill before financial year 2020-21. This is very important. So if any goodwill is purchased before 2020-21, depreciation claimed on it has to be adjusted from the block of asset in which it was included before, and it has to be adjusted. It has to be seen whether any short-term capital gain is arising or not. If it is not arising, simply we will deduct the amount from the relevant block of asset. It may also happen that the value of block of asset comprises only of goodwill. We'll simply remove the block of asset. It will not be treated as capital loss or capital gain. Thank you. If any person wants to refer to particular notification, please open the notification via going through this link. Link has been provided in it. Thank you for listening us. Thank you for visiting to our channel, and we will be regularly coming with more videos, more clarification, more contents on tax topics, both on income tax and GST, and including MCA and everything regarding tax compliance in India. If you like our video, if you like our clarifications given by us via this short videos and contents, please like our channel, do subscribe our channel. Thank you.